incentives and creating large-scale opportunities for new vendors to enter the UK market. And third, addressing the existing structure of the supply market by investing in research and development and building partnerships between operators and vendors that will mean operators using multiple vendors in a single network will become the standard across the industry. Success will, of course, require a shared commitment between government and industry to take the necessary steps to address this issue. We are already engaging extensively with operators, vendors, and governments around the world about supporting and accelerating the process of diversification. And, of course, we recognise that this is a global issue that requires international collaboration to deliver a lasting solution. So we're working with our Five Eyes partners and our friends around the world to bring together a coalition to deliver our shared goals. Now, I know in addition that many members of this House have considered the government's policy on high-risk vendors in the context of the United Kingdom's wider relationship with China. Let me assure members that this government is clear-eyed about China. We have been robust in our response to the imposition of new security laws in Hong Kong, including through our generous offer to British national overseas passport holders. What we want is a modern and mature relationship with China, based on mutual respect, where we're able to speak frankly when we disagree, but also to